with me is Tom Hack, who is the founder of the HR Trend Institute, an HR veteran and HR visionary. You just had your presentation about
The psychology of people analytics, I talk about. That's good. Bias, cognitive biases.
Yes. There were lots of people in the audience.
Yeah, of course.
And I really enjoyed the way you started off, because you said the science is there from psychology and also from other disciplines for a number of years now about what we should be doing in organizations, but we're still not doing them. You gave the example of interviews, that we're still interviewing people for jobs, whereas we know that that's not the best way. So you spoke about some of these barriers or fears perhaps that people block, and you have worked in many organizations. What would you say are the couple of fears and barriers that still hold back organizational development, the adoption of science and new knowledge?
There's a couple of things I can say about it. So one is, I would say, sometimes it's a lack of imagination. You need some type of imagination. Wow, we can do other things. Life can be different. And so imagine, and that's not always there, because people are so locked up in their organization.
But is it maybe also related to some kind of existential anxiety that if I try something, if I do it different?
Fear is an element. So if you don't have the imagination, you don't know what to do. So you need imagination, but also you need the courage to do things. So sometimes it's a lack of courage. It's also in HR. So I'm talking about that people are all, sometimes they are looking for the ultimate solution. The solution that solves all your problems. And some of the companies are here, so I don't... I don't name them, but some companies are pushing that. They say, we have the ultimate solution.
And so you don't need to do the 10 year steps, but just go there.
But it takes a lot of money, a lot of time, and the reality is the ultimate solution is never there.
Yeah.
But so that while you are waiting for the ultimate solution, you're not doing so.
There's inaction.
There's waiting.
Stagnation. Yeah.
So imagination, fear, looking for the ultimate solution. Also, in English, the word I think is subversive. And sometimes HR is a little bit too much. They go to management and say, "What should we do?"
Uh-huh.
Yeah, with the head in the hand.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
What should we do?
Management
says, "Well, you know," and then okay, we'll do it.
Yeah.
And the opportunities are big, as you said. So there's scientific evidence. Today there's technology, which enables a lot of things, and there's many cool solutions here on Toekomst Personaal. A lot more probably this year than even last year.
Yes, it's quite impressive.
So there's many, but the question is, are we going to use them?
But then I find that also in other areas on the intersection of digital and human, that we tend to put a lot of pressure almost or expectation on the digital, and then somehow take a step back on what does it mean to be human, what is the human skills, and it's a little bit that as well is waiting for the magic software to give us the solution, instead of saying we can already develop a lot by mindfulness, by listening, by speaking,
absolutely.
And then how can we build up our own capabilities and then supplement it with the right technology?
But the trend has been, as you know, If you say the people and management, the trend has been away from the people for years.
Yeah.
Because HR was, we are a management. We need to belong with management. So they drove away from it. So now you see a little bit coming back. But as you say, it's not technology versus people. It's how can you do both? I'm a little bit positive that I see movement back to people-centric.
Absolutely.
So I see that moving.
Yeah.
And now you can see how can we combine a human-centric approach with the technology, with digital. So I think if you do the two together, that would be... But it's often seen as opposites.
Yeah.
Oh, digital is not human. If we are aligned with management, we... we are not close to the employees.
There are going to be about 17,000 visitors here.
Yeah.
What would be your advice as a seasoned HR professional to human resource professionals? What they should be mindful about? What is it that, if you know, they should be mindful and think, okay, how can I prioritize? What do I need to be watching out
it's
for?
It's always good to know a little bit what you're looking for, because if you say, well, you know, I don't know, then you don't see things. So if you say, well, I have a couple of things I'm looking for.
Preparing. For 2018, what do you think will be the one thing that will come up or that is coming and will surprise people, or maybe
I hope
technology?
I would hope. And there are a couple of areas where not a lot of things have happened. And I would hope that some things are happening there. So that one is, you could say, the whole area of productivity, performance consulting, productivity. How can we help people to become better? That's not really covered. And connected to that is learning and development. Because the whole area of learning and development, I think, there's so many opportunities and they are not grasped, because people use old thinking, they innovate old thinking. So I see many innovations in the learning and development domain, but basically it's online catalogs.
So that's exactly the word I wanted to say, is taking the catalogs online and you can browse like Netflix from the catalog instead of looking holistically at organizational development.
Yeah.
And also, because our bread and butter is, of course, work-life balance, is how to give people the flexibility so they can go and learn in their own time to develop outside.
And learn and things they need.
Yeah.
But then I need to, that's back to the people center. I need to really be close to you and find out what you need. And then tailor solutions that really are... But I think there's a lot of room. So I would hope that in 18 we see things moving in that arena, as well as the performance
kind of breaking the glass ceiling a little bit. On
because
that
recruitment is well covered.
Yes,
a lot of development there.
Thank you very much.
Good to meet you.
You can go on Tom's website at
that's the HRTrendInstitute.com.
Yes,
HRTrendInstitute.com.
And then you will see a lot of valuable content and blogs.
Yeah.
Or go on the worklifehub.com to see other very valuable insight and content.